Oh, hello. It's IWT Xtra 6, and this is a Flaming Turnbuckles version of IWT Xtra. All the turnbuckles have been set on fire for no apparent reason.
Yes. Here comes the icon max damage. By the way, this is Canadian Gauge commentating.
Yes, we are definitely greater than Damaged Legacy.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Yeah. Should be commentating. They're so bad that John Blood got shit.
And oh my god, here comes Brent Harv.
Heal Brent Harv.
Yes. For some odd reason. I don't know why that is, but okay. And Brent telling Max Damage to go suck it.
Only two of the turnbuckles are on fire. This match is faulty.
Yes, clearly. Well, the third turnbuckle is clearly also on fire. I can't tell why the fourth turnbuckle is not on fire.
This is a faulty match. A knife edge chop. Woo!
And intense stare down and Brent Harvinator with some punches.
Headlock takeover by Brent Harvinator. And who do you think's gonna win this match?
I don't know. Both of these guys are in their debut match here in IWT, so we don't know what to expect from either of them, really.
True. The winner of this match could get a big momentum push. I don't know, something. There's Flippy Shit by Brent Harvinator.
Oh my god, Flippy Shit. That is very important in IWT. We do a lot of Flippy Shit here.
That's how everyone gets over.
Oh, another knife edge chop.
Max Damage, the king of knife edge chops.
Yes. And also the master of the damage gauge, which is signature jackhammer. And another knife edge chop. And also we have a lot of Nexus shirts out in the arena. Maybe stalling because the movement comes out.
Yes, obviously. Yes, they're the only ones people are here to see.
And also, you see a Matt Icorn shirt flashing with a guy who's changing his shirts every second to the I'm also in Miz shirt, too.
You can see a DX sign, too, even though they're not here.
Oh my god. And also some Sprite Nation signs out there in the audience.
And there's Tori.
Yes.
And
Brent Harvinator seems fired up, but Max Damage is coming back with knife edge chops.
That's all this match has been. What's he going for? Oh, good!
That finisher move he does.
The reverse knee leg drop, cover one, go.
Yes, the reverse knee leg drop.
What are you going to do with reverse KLD to score the PIN?
Yes. And when I first read that move, I still have no idea what it is.
So Brent, if you're watching this, you must explain to us how a reverse knee leg drop works.
Well, he explained it to me as being a hog lock, finally a Big Show, but really the wording made no sense to me. Oh, what's Brent going for?
Oh, he's gonna choke him out! No.
And Max Damage with the clever ring awareness to get to the ropes.
Brent Harvinator coming back with those knife edge chops, shades of Max Damage. Max Damage is a back suplex.
Awesome back suplex right there. And oh! Kick to the face by Brent Harvinator. And trying to go for those, I don't know, quite like martial arts type kicks. Straight to the face.
Kicks and chops, that's what this match has been.
Yes.
Headlock.
Yes,
but some real wrestling.
We can see the actual split turnbuckle is on fire, but we can't.
Oh shit!
But it's in 2D dimension, so we can't see it.
It's a two-dimensional fire.
Yes, it's a two-dimensional fire. See, the turnbuckle is on fire.
It is.
Yes, we can only see it in that dimension. It's a one-dimensional fire. And so far, none of these guys have seemed to use the turnbuckle, even though they are on fire.
They're too busy using chops and kicks.
Yes, making the match pointless, essentially, but whatever.
All that big kick, surprisingly, from Brent Harvinator.
And oh, he finally grabs the leg. And
Dragon Screw leg whip.
Yep. And max damage. Shoots him off the ropes.
Irish whip.
Oh, nice.
Big lariat.
Big, big lariat. And an elbow.
Elbow to the face. What's he going for? Looks like
another kick. And a second kick. And a grapple. And a suplex.
Snap suplex. Shades of lightweight wrestlers.
Yes. And
punch the face.
And amazingly, rope break. I don't know how that works, but yes, rope break.
A punch is a submission. And a kick over the rope. And what's he going for?
And he's taunting to the crowd because he's here.
Telling the movement to suck it.
No, he cannot tell the movement to suck it.
He's like tipsy up.
Doesn't he know the repercussions of taunting the movement?
Doesn't he know the repercussions of not joining the movement?
Yes, I know, right? You're either in the movement or you're not in the movement. And the fire is blazing.
Using the fire, kicks him over the ropes.
And an elbow. Back and he's talking to the fire. He tells the fire to go suck it.
That's how the crowd to suck it. Army are completely control now. What's he going for? Spinning Hurricanrana.
And he forgot that there's no pins on the outside.
And he's just having some fun.
And what's he gonna go for here? The reverse knee leg drop.
The reverse KLD on the outside.
Amazing move, right there. And oh my god, he's climbing the turnbuckle! His feet are gonna be on fire! Oh shit!
Oh my god!
And there's no pinfalls on the outside. Brent, seriously. See, we're right here in front of you, okay? And they come back into the ring, and now Brent's arm is on fire.
Fire, but he no sells it.
And finally, he's in the fire! This is worse than the Inferno match on any SVR game.
STF applied. Shades of...
Maybe he will overcome the odds, just like John Cena. And, a couple of... axe handle right to the face.
Another knife edge chop straight to the chin.
And oh shit! Max damage has caught the leg! And another.
I think they're dragging through leg whip.
Yes. This is a great match. And we're also looking forward to our main event where the Mountie Otto, who is totally not the guy who I'm commentating with right now, is gonna take on the X Division champion, Jason Matthews.
Yes, and I talked to Otto backstage since we're good friends. And he plans on winning that title and actually unifying it with the SEX World Championship, which he holds, and turning it into the SEXX Division Championship of the world.
Oh shit. That is amazing. I would love to see that happen. And Max Damage, what's he going for here? Oh, big, huge
suplex.
I think he might be calling for the end here.
Could be going off the damage gauge.
Yes, he's got him hooked.
Picks him up.
And that
could be the damage gauge, stalling.
He's stalling for it. And oh,
that's a damage gauge. 1, 2, 3. Fucking, that's it.
Max Damage has won his debut match here in IWT. Big, big things to come from him.
You're seeing the damage gauge. Yeah, let's pick him up, getting his a big victory over heel Brent Harvinator after he survived him. 2 reverse knee leg drops.
Amazingly. Yeah, I think it was that point where he threw him finally into that fiery turnbuckle, which turned around this match.
Yes.
And we'll be back after a commercial break. Any SE ad, lol.
Yes. Everyone should watch it. Here we see it.
So what is TWL? And oh my god, here we are in the main event of IWT Xtra 6. The X Division Championship is on the line in this match. Even though it says light heavyweight. For some weird reason.
That's really just X Division spelled backwards.
Yes, it is. And oh my god, here he comes. He's the Mountie.
He's the greatest Mountie
in the world. And he's so the Lord.
He thinks he's cute and he knows he's sexy.
Yes.
And he's like the party Mountie Otto.
Yes, that's it. He is great. And oh my god, he came to play. One of the more famous people in. And why is he accompanied by Chris Stratton? Since when did women like him? And again, the turnbuckles are on fire.
Exploding turnbuckles match.
Oh, a big boot by Jason Matthews set the tone of this match.
And punches to the face.
He wants to win his first defense here in IWT after he was simply awarded the belt by suspect out of sheer pity.
That's the greatest way to win the title. Always yes. By suspect. I just went by the Mountie Otto.
Yes.
You must, running neck breaker.
You must become the chosen one, like Sin Cara.
Yes.
That is the best way to get pushed in IWT, and also to be black. Being black helps.
Is it too late for him to be born black? We don't know. We're going to find out this match.
Yes. And there... Otto thinking here? And
Otto sick him out, and a big plancha, crossbody plancha, and an elbow drop to the foot.
Yes. He's trying to weaken that foot. Maybe he's going to think about a sharpshooter or something Canadian like that.
Sharpshooters are very Canadian, just like Matt, just like Otto.
Yes.
Here we go, put back to the ring. Lariat, no! Otto versus he's Canadian.
Oh my god. He is Canadian.
Goes behind him, what you going for in that forearm to the back. Let's go for Boston Crab, Walls of Jericho, who's Canadian, but no, Jason Matthews gets out.
And as we can see, three of the turnbuckles are still lit up with a one-dimensional fire. They can only be seen in one dimension.
Yes, you can only be burned. You can only be burned on one side.
Yes.
Running elbow drop.
And oh my god, Jason Matthews has cornered him into the fire turnbuckle.
Oh my god, the Canadian's true weakness is fire.
Yes. And Jason Matthews is looking very pale today. He needs I think he may need a tan after this match.
He does too. He's been spending too much time with his pale friends.
Sheamus.
And IWT's Blake.
Yes, and IWT's Blake. They are totally two different people. And
yes, obviously.
Oh, and Jason Matthews keeps trying to use a big boot. But it's not, doesn't seem to be working so far. And oh, nice.
Oh, forearm to the back.
And
he starts it up. And this could be it. He could be setting him up for that Canadian move. No, club to the back.
What is the Mountie Otto thinking of? And oh shit, he
used
the signature move of Jason Matthews against him.
Yes, he stole his own finisher.
Yes, the impressive but awesome roll-up. Oh shit! The Mountie Otto says it's over. Oh my god, he's on the top turnbuckle.
He's going up the flaming turnbuckle.
And the elbow drop.
The flaming elbow drop.
And he's going to go again. And oh, this time Jason Matthews got out of the way.
He's able to dodge Otto's Canadian elbow drop. Irish with no reverses.
Oh, and a hip punch.
Fixing back up. Could be going for that Canadian move. No, swinging neck breaker. No! Jason Matthews counters into a running neck breaker drop of his own.
What is Jason Matthews thinking? Oh, he put him into the flaming turnbuckle. That's good.
Quickly getting out and trying to throw him to the outside, maybe. Back elbow strike.
And once again, the Mountie Otto feels that it may be time for his super kick.
This is patented Canadian super kick from Blant Storm.
And Oh. He was gonna go for a Death Valley driver maybe of some kind, but Mountie Otto managed to counter it.
That's what he does best, counters and submissions.
Cause he's Canadian. And what's he going for here? He's going for
it. Picks him up like a suplex, holds him up there, a solid suplex, showing great strength.
Yes, I know. Drops him straight down on his back.
Dancing, that heart out for the Canadian fans.
Says it's all over once again.
This could be it. This be that Landstorm super kick, yes? Yes!
And oh, Jason!
No!
Jason Matthews don't tell that shit.
Jason Matthews says fuck you, Canada. He gets back up. Irish whip, no! Auto reverses and a hip toss.
And once again, the Mountie Otto dancing his way
into the hearts of fans.
Yes. Yes, all eight of them.
One, two, three. And I am seven of those fans.
Yes. Remember, this will be on the next episode of Car Nitpicking, possibly.
Yes, by Pikachu Fan 200.
Yes. And what is... Oh, he got him dazed. I think he's gonna go for it again. Oh, and
he just DDT.
Yes, that DDT. Okay, this time he says for sure it's the end.
This has gotta be it.
Going for it, and a super kick.
He kicks it.
And his head ran right into that flaming turnbuckle.
Yes, he's gotta be dead. Cover.
One, two,
yes!
And we have a new champion!
A new X Division champion! Otto! My brain is
falling! Yes!
And I for the long!
Yes, that was a very smart move, and we can still see the one dimensional fire!
Yes, it's coming in on its turn!
They're from the ropes, but yeah. That was an impressive match there. Well, that was Canadian Gauge. Thank you, and good night. I love pancakes.